Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Stunning scripture again for us today. St. Paul depending totally on the power of the Holy Spirit, something that we still struggle with. And Jesus, I don't think you've ever heard of a group of people having one opinion, then seconds later, 220% the opposite. Let us be open to the gifts of the Spirit and learn from the teaching of St. Paul. Compassionate One, you are good and forgiving to all who call on you. Lord, have mercy. Living water, you are refreshment for the thirsty soul. Christ, have mercy. Risen Lord, your love is better than life. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. One of the ways we're recognizing, realizing, experiencing the power of the Spirit is this moment of deliberately, consciously uniting ourselves here in the building, but with the church gathering with us online as well. Let us pray. God of might, giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care, keep safe what you have nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Says the Lord, anyone who follows me will have the light of life.
when he comes to earth.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, and went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day, as he usually did. He stood up to read, and they handed him the scroll of the prophet Isaiah. Unrolling the scroll, he found the place where it is written, "The Spirit of the Lord has been given to me, for he has anointed me. He has sent me to bring the good news to the poor, to proclaim liberty to captives, and to the blind new sight, to set the downtrodden free, to proclaim the Lord's year of favour." He then rolled up the scroll, gave it back to the assistant, and sat down. And all eyes in the synagogue were fixed on him. Then he began to speak to them. "This text is being fulfilled today, even as you listen." And he won the approval of all. And they were astonished by the gracious words that came from his lips. They said, "This is Joseph's son, surely?" But he replied, "No doubt you will quote me the saying, 'Physician, heal yourself,' and tell me, 'We have heard all that happened in Capernaum. Do the same here in your own countryside.'" And he went on, "I tell you solemnly, no prophet is ever accepted in his own country. There were many widows in Israel, I can assure you, in Elijah's day, when heaven remained shut for 3 years and 6 months, and a great famine raged throughout the land. But Elijah was not sent to any one of these. He was sent to a widow at Zarephath, a Sidonian town. And in the prophet Elisha's time, there were many lepers in Israel, but none of these was cured except the Syrian Naaman." When they heard this, everyone in the synagogue was enraged. They sprang to their feet and hustled him out of the town, and they took him up to the brow of the hill their town was built on, intending to throw him down the cliff. But he slipped through the crowd and walked away. The Gospel of the Lord. Jesus broke the rules of the synagogue. You begin reading the scroll at the beginning, and then you continue unrolling it until you get to the end of that book, that scroll. But he wanted to read that section, "The Spirit of the Lord is on me," so he would have caused a disturbance as he rolled and unrolled and rolled to find exactly where he wanted. He's not doing the right thing. Why? But then he tells them that he is the fulfillment of the prophecy. Fantastic, impressive words. He continues to really move them. But then someone just goes, "Oi, isn't this Joseph's lad? He's nobody. They don't own land. They just have a little carpentry shop. He's someone that can be looked down upon, even in this tiny village." And then we have this explosion of anger towards him because he's telling the truth. We desire to tell the truth of the good news of Jesus Christ, and there are many, many deaf ears. What did I read the other day? 295 million of our brothers and sisters suffer extreme persecution. They don't get called a bad name. They are suffering severe persecution because they proclaim the good news of Jesus. So let's realize there is an enormous task presented to us to share the fulfillment of Isaiah. 2, be be open to the gifts of the Spirit. Jesus used them, Paul used them. Why the blazes do we feel we don't need to use them? So let's listen to the word. We will get to the point in Corinthians where we hear his amazing section telling us the gifts that are on offer. So let's pray that we will heed and respond to the word. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
On the bank holiday, sun shining at the moment, it's going to stay at least dry apparently. We pray that people will be able to recreate, and we remember especially our schools as they look forward to starting very soon. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
And we pray for those that we have been asked to pray for. Elodie, who will have surgery on Tuesday. For Ruby, a very young teenager who's been diagnosed with a brain tumour. And she's been seeing her consultant, I think they said, today. And also for Leanne with motor neurone disease. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
In silence, we offer our personal prayers. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
God of hope, your Son shows us that the cross is the way to freedom and the fullness of joy. Send us your Spirit that we may embrace the cross with gladness. May the hardships we endure for the sake of the gospel lead all the world to the joy of salvation. Through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruits of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. And sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May all the sacrifice
of salvation, that what it celebrates in mystery it may accomplish in power through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna.
Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. When
we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Mark, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, forever and ever. Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And we pray together. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who were called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
The blood of Christ.
Amen.
Thank you. pray. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that, being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and stir us to serve you in our neighbour. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
If you are at all able, please do bring in some tins of fruit, packets of mash or tins of potatoes, and then I can take them to the food bank for tomorrow night. Let us pray. O sailing victim, opening wide the gate of heaven to man below, our foes press on from every side, thine aid supply, thy strength bestow. To thy great name be endless praise, immortal Godhead, one in three. O grant us endless length of days, in our true native land with thee. Amen. the sins. Jesus' way, gate to salvation, shepherd and lamb, resurrection and life. Jesus condemned to death, crowned with thorns, wounded by stings of the lash. Jesus nailed to the wood of the cross, buried in the earth, rising from the dead. Jesus descended into hell, ascended into heaven, giver of the Holy Spirit. Jesus, hope of the bride, reward of the just, abundance of the kingdom. The response is now, to you praise and glory. To you praise and glory. Jesus, living God, to you praise and glory. Jesus, alive in your church, to you praise and glory. Jesus, living for ages unending, to you praise and glory. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who in Christ revealed your glory to all the nations, watch over the works of your mercy, that your church, spread throughout the world, may persevere with steadfast faith in confessing your name, through Christ our Lord. this great sacrament revere. Types and shadows have their ending, for the newer rite is here. Faith, our outward sense befriending, makes the inward vision clear. Glory let us give and blessing to the Father and the Son, honour, might and praise addressing, while eternal ages run. Ever to his love confessing, who from both, with both, is one. Amen. Let us pray. Lord, may this sacrament of new life warm our hearts with your love and make us eager for the eternal joy of your kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. O sacrament most holy.